Salvage Supremo Drew Pritchard has been up since the early hours at a Snow Hit antique market in Worcestershire.
How much are these, John?
They've got to be 10 each.
Marvellous. Thank you.
He's on the hunt for lots of quality items and has just snapped up a collection of colourful pottery from this German dealer who's packing up to leave.
Excellent. Happy with that. Today's been great. I do love coming to these fairs. When it comes right down to it, I've bought well, and I've bought quite a lot. And then all of those art pots, I think they're fantastic. I want people to walk into my shop and be able to walk out with something, but know that everything in there I've chosen myself.
Drew and T have driven 70 miles south to Welshpool in the county of Powys.
Here we are, prime spot.
Right outside. Brilliant.
Ian.
Oh,
hello,
Andrew.
Mate. How are you?
I'm very well.
Good
how
to see
you?
You.
Good to see you.
Thank you. Hi, I'm T. How are you doing?
Morning. Good morning.
Thank you very much.
Good.
T needs to see this.
I've not been in the shop.
Haven't you?
No.
Look at this staircase. This is amazing.
Yeah, the staircase is early 17th century. No, it is an amazing staircase.
Wow.
I love it. Can we have a look up there later? Because that's not open to the public, that bit, is it?
It isn't, no.
It
but
isn't.
You,
can I?
You can go.
But to me,
yeah,
that,
of course you can. You know, no problem at all.
Yeah. Should we have a look at it?
Where you go?
This tea now,
yeah,
is a proper antique shop.
Okay. How yours should be.
This is a proper, real antique shop. There's not many left. Yeah. It's really good.
It's
that's lovely. Yeah. My favourite timber. We were talking about this yesterday.
Yeah. Coromandel.
It's just, I don't own anything Coromandel that I've had to always sell it. Mmm. Mmm. Smells lovely.
It's nice, lovely little box. Nice order too. It's
original lock, original key.
Yeah.
Original escutcheon, a little bit of fruitwood banding.
It's very nice. And even got the old bit of bays on the bottom.
Yeah, beautiful. Age? 1830s.
1830s, smack on we are. It's just a little box, but it's very nice.
The trinket box is partly made from Coromandel wood, which originates in Sri Lanka. The wood has almost been logged to extinction, making pieces like this valuable and highly desirable. It could be worth around £250. Enthusing over period pieces of furniture is one thing, but Drew's only bought one item so far, and his mission today is quality and quantity.
You've got just a little bedside
okay.
pot.
Yes, yeah.
And how much did you say it was again?
I said 220. Mm. You're looking at me, are you?
Well, I'm just having a, you know, just I couldn't remember.
200 quid to an old friend.
Price for the pot cupboard, £200. A little bit of work, we'll get 325 for it.
And 80 miles down the road in Evesham is an antiques warehouse that Drew thinks could be fertile hunting ground.
Hello, mate. How you doing?
Hello. Drew.
Drew.
How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Good,
mate. Right.
Yeah, pleased to meet you.
I am T.
T, pleased
you
to
doing?
Meet you,
sir.
Right. Not too bad.
Right. Where'd you get this from?
Oh, gosh. That came out of a private house. It's nice and original inside, that is. Isn't that lovely? And I tell you what, these are good because they don't take so much space up in the hallways.
No maker's marks on it.
The only thing you've got on the back is a religious label, because it was out of a church.
Oh, it'll be that...
Robes.
Robes.
Yeah.
You see the label?
Study, pray, give.
That's my motto on life.
So you're going to give it to me?
I might study about it.
It's nice. I like it.
I just love the top of it as well. It's, like, simplistic, isn't it? Mm.
There's a wonderful, incredibly simple Gothic linen cupboard or coat cupboard. It's just right up my street, it really is. It's so beautifully drawn. Everything is just of a perfect proportion.
Dating to around 1900, this cupboard harks back to the style of Augustus Pugin, who was the leading figure in the revival of the Gothic style in the 19th century. This one has come from a church, but its simple yet classic lines make it a perfect piece of furniture for the home. It could be worth around £700.
Where'd you get that from?
That is very interesting. That came out of the middle of Bristol. So what you've got...
EW and SR First Aid.
So you've got English, Welsh and Scottish Railway First Aid Cabinet.
Oh!
With me.
OK, yeah. It's got a date on it. Is it Second World War or...?
It's got... The labels are later,
yeah.
But I think it is about that date, yeah.
Great original paint, quirky inside, fun, but pretty original. It's had a couple of bits of repainting, but then when you open up the interior, it's all there and it's got some blankets. So it's the sort of thing I was buying maybe 5 or 6 years ago, but now it's such a good piece. Can't really ignore it.
At one time, first aid cabinets like these could be found in railway stations up and down the country. Their basic design and striking original hand-painted finish could add a quirky sense of character to any home or commercial property. It could be worth around £600.
It's just down to price, really, whether I have to walk away.
OK. Would you walk away at £390?
I'll tell you what, can we just go to £350 and have it done?
£350 for the cabinet and a tenner for the key.
All right.
Hello, hello.
We've been to Manor Monkeys.
This looks like a petrol pump.
It does a bit. It's the English, Welsh and Scottish Railway first aid box. Right. It gets more interesting on the interior.
Oh, yes.
Look at this, look at this.
Oh, this is great.
Good, eh?
It's great. What did you pay for it?
£360. £550 done?
More.
Really?
Yes, I think so. We sold a cupboard slightly similar a couple of years ago, and it ended up in a hairdresser's with all the shampoo and everything and the brushes, and it looked fantastic. It's going to end up in retail.
This is lovely.
This is a good looker.
Yeah, £375.
Very nice price.
Oak, English, about 1900. It's extremely original. Beautiful condition.
Unbelievable.
Great colour. Just very, very authentic. Great proportions. You know when something can be so, so simple, so incredibly simple, but so nicely put together? That's what I like about it. Classy little piece. Cool, right.
Yeah, well done.
All yours.
Whilst the rest of the items are unloaded, Gav gets to work restoring the oversized pot cupboard that Drew bought at F.E. Anderson's.
Just needs a really good clean, really, and a wipe and a wax and a stain. I think it's quite dirty underneath. I got the job of cleaning it. Got all the good jobs done.
Gav's first task is to remove over 150 years' worth of dirt and grime from the underside of the cabinet. With the base taken care of, he moves on to the sides.
It's made out of mahogany, it's nice wood, it's nicely made. You just got to be very careful. I'm only using extra fine wire wool just to get the paint specks off and made Stanley blade. We don't want to scratch the wood.
Next job is to fix the marble top.
Right, we're going to stick this on permanently with the coloured wood glue. So once this goes off, it won't move. Hopefully.
With the marble top secured in place, Gav can finish rejuvenating the cabinet's mahogany finish.
And we're going to put stain all over this now just to fill in all the scratches and nicks and just to make it look more presentable. Don't need much stain. A little bit goes a long way. See, it looks a lot better already.
Once the stain's soaked in, the cabinet's ready for the finishing touch.
Well, it's all dry now. We can apply a wax and give it a polish. Get it nice and shiny, ready for photography. This is the part of the job I like, when you've repaired it, you've stained it, you've waxed it, and you get to polish it off and it gets to look like that when you're finished. It makes a hell of a difference. That's it, done.
Restoration complete, the pot cupboard can be put up for sale along with the rest of Drew's haul. Drew's strategy of buying quantity without sacrificing quality has paid off. The smaller pieces he bought are exactly the kind of walkout items Drew wanted for the shop.
Yep, cool.
And no sooner than they're put on display, some of the pots from Malvern are snapped up by a local couple.
They did have them walking past, didn't they?
Yeah.
And obviously we went in and saw one. And of course,
he bobbed
one became a pair, so we had them both.
Other items were listed online, and the railway first aid cabinet made its way to a customer in Winchester. And the Coromandel cigar box Drew fell in love with at F.E. Anderson is sold to a customer based in Northampton.
So, with an online business and now the shop, I'm going to be busy. I'm going to have to be out every day in places where I can pretty much guarantee I'm going to find things. I want to, every Saturday morning, open up the shop, and the quality and the things in there, I'll be proud to put my name to. And that takes a lot of work.